on a dream.
Hi, I'm Jenny McCafferty for the Michigan Runner and the Michigan Golfer, and we are here in Detroit with none other than the one and only Emily Gale. Emily, it's so exciting to see you in Detroit.
Well, I love being here, and I love, of course, you and Art and Carter Sherline and Michigan Runner put us on the map 40 years ago. So it's nothing better than to always see you and have you continue to give me support for everything I'm doing in Detroit. Down here at the Detroit Foundation Hotel, the old Detroit Fire Department headquarters where we started our races many years ago, right outside the corner here.
Okay, so I figured it was across the street from something important. So this is a very cool place, and one of the things that's very cool about you is that you now live in Hawaii and you vacation in Detroit, which is the opposite of what other people do.
I'm going to kind of correct that because I go by Emily T. Gale now, and when I come to Detroit, I'm working every day. Okay. And it's a vacation in many ways because it's just like Emily's across the street used to be. Everybody thought it looked like so much fun, and we had so much fun, but there was a lot of hard work behind it, just like you do at Michigan Golfer and Michigan Runner, right? Everybody thinks you get to go all the golf tournaments and the runs, but it's a lot of hard work. But I love coming back here. I was here for 5 weeks in June, then I went back home and then came here for 6 weeks. I'm doing some work with the Detroit Foundation Hotel here. They're so excited when they first saw the pictures of the start of the race outside the Detroit Fire Department headquarters, now the Detroit Foundation Hotel, that they kept saying, let's reboot it, let's reboot it. So when Art called and said, let's sit down and kind of do a retrospect of the race, they're getting me fired up to think about doing something again too.
Well, the hotel is exciting, and I went down the hall and there was a sign that said, don't look up. Well, of course you look up. And there were all these great balloons up there. So,
well, you know what that is? That's where the fire department, you know, this is a historical building, so they've preserved everything. And that's where they used to hang the hoses after they went out on a run so they would dry. So they put those lights up there. That's the beauty of the hotel. You know, they don't call it a hotel. They call this a restaurant with hotel rooms. And it's called the apparatus room. It's very communal spirit, as you can see. People sitting at the tables and working, doing their work and having meetings, and a wonderful area for dining. And it's just wonderful the way that they have created a community spirit here.
And speaking of community spirit, there are a few themes that really run through the amazing career you've had. One of the themes is you're an athlete, and the other thing that I think is really important is community involvement. That's really where your heart is, isn't it?
It absolutely is. And what I love about what's going on right now is we're here in the room, the windows opened up, and they're washing the windows, and people are walking by. And that's the great thing about being in the city. It's hard not to be involved in the city when you're doing things like this. Because, you just feel the energy and the activity of being in the urban environment. And in the streets of Detroit, it's like a small town. So community involvement happens very naturally.
One of the things we want to do is kind of go back to the beginning, where you had a store and it was called Emily's Across the Street. Can you tell us a little bit about how the store itself got started?
Sure. My first store was called Emily's Cameron Gift Shop. It was a 9x12 room in the Penobscot building, started in the late 60s. And then I ended up with a 500 square foot store in the First National building on the other side of Woodward, on the east side, over where near Campus Martius in Cadillac Square area. And that was about 500 square feet. And then when the Renaissance Center opened, all the financial institutions and brokerage firms moved to the Ren Center. There were a lot of vacant buildings in this neighborhood. This building right here is a big part of the neighborhood of where Emily's Across the Street was. I took an old space called DuPont & Company. It was one of the many brokerage firms that that were in this area, that suddenly were empty spaces. And it was right next door to the London Chop House, and I wanted to have a space that was bigger and more independent from being in a building with other merchants and being street level. So I took the space, and people kept saying, are you going to close this store? What are you going to do? I said, no, I'm going to have Emily's, and then I'm going to have Emily's across the street. And that's how we came up with the name of it. But it started out as kind of a Crate and Barrel store. But once we made the first Detroit T-shirt, at that time people weren't really, you know, spouting their pride in the city.
And that time would be 19?
That would be in the mid-1970s. Okay. And I was loving living in the city and love having a business in the city. And there are a lot of us that were working very hard. Chuck Muir had his jazz concerts across the street here on the top of the Pontchartrain. Every day you'd walk by the fire hall here, and the firemen were out in front, and they were polishing the fire engines and all kinds of activity. And so we became a neighborhood that had a lot of activity. Everybody was very community involved. It was still called Detroit Murder Capital of the World. So we all had a lot of work to do to get people to defy that perception.
This really went back to the rebellion of 67.
Yes, it was a carryover of a lot of things. But it was also just a wonderful spirit in which many of us, you know, were down here riding bikes, enjoying a good time, and loved advocating that people come down into the city and just come down one time, come down a couple times, and you would discover that there really were nice things to do in the city.
So your store itself was fun. You had fun things in the store.
We did. We had fun people in the store, you know, and that's what they're doing here at Detroit Foundation Hotel. I feel like they're carrying on the neighborly spirit that we had at Emily's across the street. There's our general manager from the Foundation Hotel. We might get Bob. Hey, Bob, come here and join us a little bit. You know, when Bob saw these pictures, if that's okay to just interject here, I a year ago when Detroit Foundation Hotel opened, they kind of tapped me on the corner. Does that work, Art? Okay, well, I'm probably going to get kind of teary about this, because a year ago, Bob and Amber Rose Powers, who is the lifestyle director, invited me to come to the hotel, and they had just opened, and I had already had my eye on coming and taking a look. But they knew a little bit about the neighborhood, and they just gave me such a warm welcome. So over the last year, they've listened to all my stories about the Emily Detroit runs being out front here, the Detroit Foundation Hotel, where we are, which used to be the Detroit Fire Department headquarters. And Bob, maybe you can just share the first time you started hearing about the Emily Detroit runs being outside here.
Well, first of all, I was pretty amazed at the amount of people that were at your runs. I mean, the attendance looked incredible, and the fact that they were right outside our front doors is an amazing thing. And when I looked at the first picture, I'm like, wait a minute. That is the corner of Washington and Larned. And wait a minute, the hotel is right next door to the start-finish line. So it's pretty amazing. You know, as I said, Emily, like this last year and 4 months has been incredible with your partnership and knowing what you did for this city for such a long time and what you continue to do. I'm just humbled to be in your presence and to work with you.
Well, it's an honor for me, because I feel like I'm in the old neighborhood. And what they've done is they've taken this neighborhood, you know, as I said, we deliberately started the races in those days outside this Detroit Fire Department headquarters because of the spirit of the firemen. But the Detroit Foundation Hotel, Bob Lambert and his team of Jen Lee, everybody, they've made the neighborhood spirit even greater. And when he first saw the picture, they were all saying, we got to reboot it, we got to do that run again. But I was saying that how often people come through here, right, and they'll see me and they'll talk about them in the races, or you maybe like to speak to that.
Absolutely. I mean, the history of this building and the history of this corner and what you were doing with the runs, and then what this building meant to so many people over the years, whether they're firefighters that were in their families, they're now retired, coming back to look at where they used to work. The story that I tell most frequently is about a 92-year-old firefighter that came in with his daughters one day, and the daughters said, it's like, you know, he doesn't have a lot of short-term memory anymore, but his memory of this place, this building, is vivid. And I walked around with him for 45 minutes all throughout the space, and he was like, hey, the kitchen used to be over here. Is this where the kitchen still is? And we used to park over here, and my office was over here. And it was those type of emotional stories and emotional connections to this building and this community, this Shelby and Commerce and Washington is just unbelievable. And so we're just, you know, we just want to contribute to what it is, to the Detroit story and what continues to happen in the city.
And how many times we're sitting in here maybe having a meeting and someone comes in that says they used to go to Emily's or they used to run in the run.
Unbelievable. Yeah, unbelievable. Going to the run, you know, and again, I think there's a concerted effort to, you know, for us, it's about not forgetting the past. And it's such a huge piece of what we do, because an adaptive reuse project is something that we need to maintain the legacy of the building and continue to tell the story. It's just not all about us in this current moment. It is about what came before us. And so, you know, our ability to continue to tell those stories is important to us.
And the Great Lakes Sports Publication and Art McCafferty and Ginny and the whole Michigan Runner, who were pioneers when they started Michigan Runner, because nobody was writing about runs or talking about runs, and I always say they put us on the map, but they continued to do the same thing for many runs for 40 years. But I love having the opportunity to have this retrospect of the past and be able to include it in what you're doing here. And I know, who was it, Kevin? From Robinson,
yep.
From the Imperium Hotels, who is the parent company here. He happened to be here on a weekend that we were doing a project together, and he saw the pictures and was like, we got to do this again in some form. So whatever we do, Michigan Runner will be part of what we decide that we're going to do.
Absolutely.
Well, thanks for joining us. I'm glad we're able to do this down here and introduce the Michigan Runner to the apparatus room and the community spirit here. As you always say, it's a restaurant with hotel rooms, but what it is, and maybe talk a little bit about how you're that community spirit and wanting to have community events down here.
Yeah, a large part of why we build restaurants and bars first is for that sense of community. You know, the hotel component is very important to us, of course. We are a hotel, but the apparatus room is a place for the community to connect. We want people to come into this space. You don't have to buy anything. You can pop open your laptop, use our Wi-Fi, work on whatever you need to, but be a part of what is going on downtown. And so and we want to be the conduit to bring people together, so that people of all segments of our community come and connect and do business and make Detroit better. If we can do that, then we're doing something.
Every single day they let me come in and tell stories about the Emily Detroit runs right outside here and the parties and the great spirit that was brought into the city. And once again, I have to acknowledge Michigan Runner for the support they gave us for so many years. Every day of the week, something different is going on here. Tonight, you know, they have different music events in the evenings. During the day, people are here mixing and mingling, having meetings, doing photo shoots. Snapchat was here the other day. Bill Ford was here doing the interview in their podcast studio yesterday. So it's just a hub of community activity.
Well, it's a fun place, and it really mixes the very contemporary with really retro architecture, so it's just a fun place.
You know, as they say, they call it a restaurant with hotel rooms. And they say, come to dine at the apparatus room and much more. And that's what happens here. People meet here and then they engage with each other. I just want to dream.